Hello everyone, welcome to Let's DevOps, myself Sumit, and today we are going to discuss about how to build Docker image, scan it for any vulnerability, and then push to the ECR, means Azure Container Registry or any other registry using the GitHub action. So before we start, I would like to request to subscribe my channel and blog site for future update if you haven't done it. For all the discussion and demo, I will be following this article, and the link of this article you can find under the video description. So let's start. So first is introduction. In this article, we will learn how to build a Docker image. Further, we will scan it for any vulnerability and then we'll push it to the ACR or any other Docker registry also. ACR is like we are pointing to the Azure Container Registry. Now let's talk about the CI/CD workflow. So all the required file, the Docker file or a project file, we will keep in the GitHub, and with the help of GitHub action, first we'll try to build a Docker image, then we will scan it. And after the scan, if there is any vulnerability, then we will send a notification to the respective team to look into the issue. If there is no vulnerability, then we will push the images either to the Azure Container Registry, or maybe you can configure to push to any other Docker registry. So next is prerequisites. So in this we will see what are the required action that you need to perform before you start setting up the YAML workflow. So first is the Docker file. Yes, so you should have a Docker file, and then that Docker file only we need to build the image, right? So that Docker file should be pushed to the GitHub. The second is some of the credential you need. Like assume that if I want to build and push my image to Azure Container Registry, I need the credential, right? Then only I can push to that the Azure Container Registry. Similarly, if you have a Docker Hub, you need the credential, right? So those information you should have, so that it will helpful for our next step to configure that all the setup. Okay, so how to get this access detail? So assume that if you are using the container registry, you can connect to Azure, go to the respective container registry, and under the access key you will find the login server, username, and that password. So from there you will get all the three details, right? Next is workflow details. So I have created a sample workflow file. You can it is publicly available, and you can find it here. So these are the content of that particular the YAML or a workflow file. So let's go and review this file. So let's click on it. So first, if you see this YAML, first we are giving the name, right? And on the as an input, we are asking users to provide the image version, because whenever you build a Docker image, you need to provide the name of the image, you need to provide the version, right? And then third, we need to provide the path of the Docker file, right? So this is something that it will be, in this case it is related relative to the GitHub. So if I go to this particular GitHub account, under the sample Docker file, this is my sample Docker file, and it is nothing but some of that it is trying to get some the Ubuntu image, and then it is trying to add some of the files, trying to give some permission. So it is some sample Docker file. In your case, you will have already a Docker file, and that you can use it. So before, as we mentioned in the prerequisites only, you should first import your Docker to the GitHub repo, right? So let's go back to that our workflow. Okay, so if you see here, these are the three required input that user has to give. This one you can either ask user to provide, or maybe you can hard code as per your requirement. Okay, the second is the job we have, where we are building, scanning, and then we are pushing. So first step, what we are doing, we are building the Docker image. The second, what we are doing, we are scanning it, and then we are pushing it to the container registry in our case. So the first step here, if you see, we are providing some secret. So as mentioned before, you need, wherever your container registry is, you need to provide the credential, right? Then only it will try to log in. So first it will try to log in with the respect of your login ECR detail. So you need to provide this username and password. So here, if you see these details, I have configured in a settings, right? So maybe either you can create in a secrets, or maybe you can create in a key vault also, and then you can read that from there also. So in our case, we have just given under the, we have created under the action. So here you basically, you can come here and then you can click on new repository secret, you can put the name here and then you can add the value. Okay, so let's go back to that our workflow. Okay, so after so once you provide this configuration, then the next is like we need to build a Docker image. So this is the command, the Docker build, and this is the path, right? So this is the path where you're providing the Docker file path, and this will be the T is like the tag or the target. So first is that our ACR server name, second is the name of the image, and then third is that image version. So this is how basically we create image, right? After that, we are having AquaSec security scanner. So this is one of that open source available, and Aqua security you can also check online, where you just need to provide the reference of the image, and then it will try to scan your image. So here we are providing the image reference, right? And after that, it is trying to upload that scan in our security tab here, right? So first of all, if you see here, after the scanning, if there is any vulnerability, like assume that if you have a high alert, right? So something like if it is high, then only you may block your image to be post, right? If there is no high alert, maybe if it is medium or low, it's all depends on your scenario. But in our case, if it is not high, then we are pushing it to the ACR. Okay, so let's go there again and see that. Okay, after that we are once that scan is complete, then we are pushing it to the ACR, right? So now we have reviewed this the workflow. Let's go to the next step. So here is how to configure. So assume that if you want to configure in your workflow, you need to either fork or you need to get this file from this particular location. This is like publicly available, so you can get it from here. After that, you can create these secrets, because this is important. Assume that if you want to push your image to the ACR, Azure Container Registry, you need to have the server detail, registry user, and registry password. As of now, we are creating in a secret. If you want to maintain in key vault, that is also fine. The third is like you need to provide this the image version, image name, and Docker path. This is also important. Either you can configure to have hard coded in YAML, or maybe you can ask user to provide. And then that's all. So next is like importing your Docker file. So once you are done with all these four step, you can go ahead and run your the pipeline or workflow. Sorry. So let's go for a demo. Yeah, so first I'll go to that my GitHub account, and I'll go to the action, and then here I have the build, scan, and push Docker image. I'll go to the run workflow. Here, as you know, like we are having the image version 2.0, the name I have given as a demo image, and then if I want to keep a default value, that's okay, but it's all up to you. So assume that if I want to change the version, and then I'll click on a run workflow. So as part of this this particular workflow execution, so what it will do, first we are doing the scan, sorry, first we are building the Docker, then we are scanning it, and then we are pushing it to the Azure Container Registry. So you can see all the logs here. Okay, so I'll pause the video for a second. Now the workflow has successfully been run. So if you see here, in this step we are trying to build the Docker image, and then we are running this particular scan. This is a AquaSec security scan we are doing, and after that we are trying to publish that particular result in the GitHub security tab, that I will show you now. Okay, so after that's done, it is then pushing that image to the Docker ACR. So this is also completed. So if I go to the security tab here, if I go to the code scanning alerts, so these are that all alerts which has come, right? So if assume that if I want to check for my high, right, or maybe if there is any critical alert or issue on that particular image, then it will show up here, right? So that also you can check. And then if you want to maybe I want to click for this medium, right, and I want to open this particular, you can see the details of all the vulnerability, what are the issue, how you can resolve it, how you can maybe create an issue so that your team member can work on it. So that's all with the demo. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any issue while your setup, you can write in the comment. I'll be responding to that. And if you like this video, kindly subscribe it and share it as well. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.